In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the default settings for Scribus so that you don't have to do that every time that you open a document. When you first open Scribus, you're going to see a page that looks something like this. I'm going to cancel this because I don't want to open a new document yet. Instead, I want to go to File, and then under Preferences, select Preferences, and then we can start with General Preferences. And as you see, these General Preferences are places or language, theme, which we probably don't want to play with. We've already set English when we installed the default fonts for the menus and palettes is fine. You may want to change this to be more specific to where you're going to store your documents. I'm going to leave it as is. So what I do want to look at are the document settings. Default in Scribus is to go to the European format A4. Since we're working in the United States, I think we should change that to letter. And that will give us our typical 8.5 by 11 inch paper. Now, you'll notice portrait orientation is fine, but the units are set to points. And for our purposes, we probably want to have that in inches. When I change that to inches, you see then the width of the page or document is going to be 8.5 inches by 11 inches, which is the standard letter size. Now, the other thing that I want to look at are my margins. Notice that the points got transformed into this rather strange setting size in inches. I just think we should do 1/2 an inch. So if I just delete all the content after the first 5, it will automatically reset to 1/2 inches. So now all of my margins are 1/2 inch. If I look at the printer margins, you'll see that the printer margins are set up to 0. That means that we'd be able to print, if the printer supported it, print all the way out to the end of the page. So we don't need to worry about that at the moment. So we have everything basically here that we want to set up. So we just click Apply. And we are done with this particular document settings. When we look at guides, again, you may want to play with this some later on when we start looking at grid. I'm going to turn on Show Grid so that when I open a new document, the grid is going to automatically open. And again, I want to apply. Then we also could look at typography. There's really nothing here that we need to play with at the moment, but in the future, if you needed to, you might be able to look at that. On tools, you could set up your default font here. I'm just going to leave it for Arial point size 12 for the moment and use the black as the text color. So again, I have nothing to change here. Hyphenation, probably nothing. Fonts, we're just going to use the default fonts. If you go to the printer setting, you can see what you can set up your default printer. I'm going to save it as PDF to be my default, since I probably would be creating mostly PDF files that will then subsequently print. So I have nothing here to change. And you scroll down and you can see there are other things. We're not going to worry about color or PDF exports right now. So pretty much we've looked at everything that we would need to look at for a new setting for new documents. So I want to click on OK. And then I want to go back to open a new project. Now, we know here that we have single page, double-sided, threefold, fourfold. These are for trifold or quadrifold brochures that are printed on they're intended to be folded so by separate columns. That's not the same thing as what we're going to be doing for our exercise. We're going to be using single columns on multiple columns on a single page. So we're going to keep the single page as the default and what we want to do for this particular document. So we'll just let that default and we click OK. And you see now I have a document that is ready to be worked on with the grid already displayed. All right, now that we have gotten our default settings set up, we want to just look very quickly at the tool ribbon here. Until you get used to it, it's not very pretty. So, actually, you'll notice that there are different tools here for different functions, and in this case, you even see a double arrow, which tells us that there are more tools that we're not seeing. So, one of the things we might want to consider doing, and I usually do this, is I will separate these so that they're easier to read. You see these little lines here. If you, and let me see if I can make the screen a little bit larger. I can, but not the menu. Not the menu. Okay, so if you can just see when I hover over the line, I get a four arrows. That allows me to move the next set of tools over to the right and gives me more room, gives me expansion, and I can do that again with the second batch, and then here we have the third batch. If I get right on the line here. And basically, in doing that, I have separated all of the various tools. So these icons over here are all functioning as file management. If you hover over them, you'll see open, save, close, print, and so on. All right, so those are pretty familiar to us. These second batch here are related to editing tools. So you see, of course, the undo and the redo, which are very familiar, a cut tool, a copy tool, and a paste tool. This section right here, the largest one, is going to be where we do most of our work. It's where we have the ability to select items, insert frames, insert images, insert a render frame, insert a table, insert shapes and lines, and so on. So we're going to be going over all of these in a lot of detail in separate videos. And then finally over here we have tools that are related to PDF, which you probably will not use. These are things such as inserting buttons for PDF or inserting forms and things like that. So we probably won't go over that in our study here, but we will be focusing primarily on these tools because they're the heart of Scribus. All right, I think that's enough for this video, so let's wrap it up and I will see you in the next video where I go over a general way to introduce you to Scribus by producing a simple document.